What's poppin'? I'm Peter, and this channel recently just hit 500 subscribers. And because I'm a creature of habit, that means another spicy Q&A. Now, I did put up a question box on my Instagram, so if you're not following me there, go check it out, otherwise you might miss stuff like this in the future. That being said, here are your best and worst questions. The way I'm going to be structuring this is there are going to be four different categories. One, YouTube questions. Two, personal questions. Three, Lego questions. And four, lightning round. Obviously, I have them all pulled up on my computer here, and I will probably reference my phone as well, because I can't remember every single question. Okay, so starting off with one of the most common questions I got, and one of the weirdest for some reason. People want to know who my LEGO YouTube crush is. Now, there are different variations of this, like Sick Bricks asks, "You simp for Ty?" And Ty asks, "Why do you have a crush on Sick Bricks?" I'm gonna be honest, I have no clue what this is about. Although maybe, just maybe, it's investigation time.
Right now I'm actually in Springfield, Illinois, because I am looking for Peter's YouTube crush. It's a burning question that I asked in his Q&A. I always follow up on what I say. I will find this person. I don't know where, but I will, okay? Excuse me, sir. Are you Peter's crush, sir? If I put my mind to something, I get it done, boys and girls. Just like Home Depot, I get it done.
The next question I got came from my friend Callum, aka Tallest Grain, who asks if I will ever make another Heelys video. Here are my thoughts on that. I think I'm going to make one in the future, but it might not be for a while, and I don't know who it will be with, because I want to do it with John, and I also want to do it with Jimmy Reese from last year's Heelys video, which, by the way, that's a year old. I do plan on making another one in the future, though. The next question is from Liam Bricks, who asks, "Who inspired me to start my channel?" And that's actually a good question, because I don't really know either. I know at the time I was probably just getting into watching The Jackhammer, and that was one of my big influences. I would also say that just generally the T-Fall community and the LEGO community at the time was one of my biggest influences. Obviously, most of the people around today were not around back then, or at least didn't really have a following back then. Yeah, I think I was just kind of inspired by all the people that I saw making videos, and I'm like, hey, I want to do that. That looks fun. And then I started and I sucked and kind of quit for 2 years and then came back to it, and that's working out great now. For those of you who haven't been around for a long time, I was only hitting like 10 subscribers back in April. Before that, I was not getting any views or any subscribers, and that's probably because I wasn't very good at making videos. But once you start like learning the fundamentals, you get exponentially better and it gets exponentially more fun. So if you're wanting to try it, try it. A similar question is, how did I get connected with everybody from YouTube? Asked by Cloudy Bricks. And that's also kind of a complicated answer. It all started back in April when I saw The Jackhammer, who was still one of my biggest influences at that time, started like a, he called it International Mock Day, and I saw that and I'm like, this is my chance. And I guess it was my chance, because that's kind of what kickstarted my whole channel. Once you start making connections, you'll start making more and more connections, and your name gets out there. It just kind of happens. And the more you work on your content, and the more you work on just improving and growing as a person and as a creator, the more respect people will generally give you. Obviously, I am not a perfect example of this, but you'll see people like Jack and Ty, who are the two biggest creators in the T-Fall community, I would say. They've both grown a ton, both as a person and in videos. So you don't have to be a perfect person and a perfect content creator, you just have to be improving. Mary Hernandez asks, new series ideas, and I actually have a couple. One, continuing the Heelys saga, since that seems to be entertaining to people. Two, I actually posted the first episode of this. I'm calling it like Part Hacks, and I don't know if that's an original name, but that's kind of the idea that I'm going for, just taking a specific part and making a video all about that part. We're also getting into the holiday season, which means there will probably be more haul videos and build videos coming from me. Probably not set reviews, but just time lapses and more random variety, spontaneous, humorous, maybe? Just more content. Cowie's Creations asks, what are my other hobbies besides LEGO besides Lego and math. Okay, I didn't realize I talked about it that much that people think math is one of my hobbies. For those of you who don't know, basically I'm just taking calculus as a junior. That's all there is to it. I'm not sure whether that's supposed to be offensive or complimentary. I do have other hobbies than Lego. One of them is band or music in general. I'm in band. Two, I've recently gotten like full on back into computers and stuff. My dad and I are actually going to be building a new computer for our family within the next month, and that is probably going to be my new editing rig, because right now I'm editing on my laptop. And my laptop works, it's just becoming more and more restrictive to use it. Another thing I know some things about is cars, and that's because of the game Forza Horizon 2, which got me back into cars. For anybody that knows anything about cars, my dream first car is a Fiat 500 Abarth. Alex Bricks coming in with a very thoughtful question. What milk do I recommend? I recommend 1%, it's what I drink. Ty wants to know, will I use this channel or hobby on my college resume? And I might. It kind of depends on what I'm going into for college, which I'm not really sure about right now. So if I end up going into something where it will be useful, I will definitely be putting it on there. And I might put it on there anyway, just because it shows that I have a life, or pretend to have a life, and that I have hobbies and put effort into things. Zbrix's burning question was, my mom could beat up your mom? I don't know, I'll ask her. You might be in the video.
Okay, why are you calling me?
Zbrix really, really wants to know if his mom could beat up you.
I would prefer that she not.
Okay, that's all I needed to know. I don't know, man, I think she'd win. Zbrix also wants to know, if I could meet anyone from the LEGO community in real life, who would it be? I think realistically, I would probably be most likely to meet Sigbrix and TDBrix, although that's probably not gonna happen for a very long time if it does. Now, if we're talking about getting a passport and flying overseas, you know I'm gonna hit you up, Zbrix. The next question is also from Ty. He also asked what my biggest LEGO flex was, and let me show you. This is a bag of disassembled Star Wars sets. This isn't really that big of a flex, but I feel like just having a bin of sets that you took apart just because you didn't want them together is kind of a flex. I mean, they're just in bags here. Like, these are all my brother's, by the way, so this is really his flex and not mine. But since we share the space and a lot of the parts, I consider this kind of the biggest LEGO flex between my brother and I. I'm also a big fan of this LEGO Technic set from 1985 that is, okay, the box isn't in mint condition. I did make a video about this, link in the description. Cal wants to know, how much LEGO do I own? My estimate is 100,000 parts between my brother and I. On Brickset, we have about 95,000 parts logged, and that is just in sets. We probably have more than 5,000 uncounted pieces, but 100,000 just sounds cool. And that is from years of collecting. We didn't just get that overnight. That is a lot of dedication and time. Bugsy Bricks wants to know, what is one set I was unable to get before it retired? That one's not too hard, actually, because last Christmas, I wanted the Creator Ferrari F40, which was technically already retired, but it was only like 120 bucks on Bricklink, which was an all right deal. I had enough money to get it, but I didn't get it because I already figured that I had already gotten a lot of Lego for my birthday and Christmas, and I didn't want to blow all my money. So I decided to wait, and that was a big mistake. Now, that Ferrari is $200 on Bricklink. That set is very good, and I want it a lot, but I really am mad at myself for not getting it last year, because it's $80 more now. How tall am I? 6 foot, or 6 foot one. Would I ever raid a Lego store if other people were doing it? No. Favorite Lego ideas set? The treehouse. I don't think it's in frame. Do you quack a lot like me? Doesn't everybody? What is your address? 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue, Northwest Washington, D.C. Does pineapple go on pizza? I'm not really a big fan of it, but you can put it on your pizza if you want. All right, lightning round over. That concludes my 500 subscriber Q&A. Hey, I have a very important message that I want to get through before everybody clicks off. I spent a really, really long time editing this video, and if you enjoyed it, and if you think it made the video better, I would appreciate it if you gave this video a like. Just simply doing that really helps me understand whether or not people like the video, or whether I should just stick with what I have been doing. I have never put this many hours into a video before, so if you like the way it turned out, please give it a like. So thank you if you did that, and thanks to everybody for 500 subscribers. I think that was the entire important message though, so does that mean I get to upload this now? It's been so long, I don't even know. Whatever the case is, thanks for watching, catch you in the next one, and see ya.